As we celebrate the golden anniversary of the protein data bank, let's look at the history and the milestones that shaped it to become the essential resource for research and education it is today. The protein data bank was established in 1971. In its first few years, the archive was very small and contained a few groundbreaking structures. For each structure, the PDB contained the three-dimensional coordinates, or the X, Y, and Z positions of each atom. How did the scientists see the atoms? Back in the 1970s, the sole method to do so was X-ray crystallography. Proteins form crystals when they are purified and concentrated. Within the crystal, many copies of the protein are arranged in symmetrical arrays. When an X-ray beam strikes the crystal, the X-rays scatter into a distinctive pattern of spots. These X-ray diffraction patterns are then analyzed to determine the positions of atoms in the protein. In 1913, the father-son team, Henry and Lawrence Bragg, were the first to describe how to interpret the X-ray diffraction patterns. They used a sodium chloride or salt crystal for their experiments. Later, the Braggs mentored many world-class researchers who used X-ray crystallography on a variety of increasingly complex substances. In 1958, using X-ray crystallography, John Kendrew determined the first atomic structure of a protein, myoglobin. With that, the field of structural biology was born. More and more scientists started to study the 3D structures of proteins, and by the early 1970s, there were a dozen atomic structures solved in different labs. Researchers around the world were interested in exploring what these 3D structures revealed. However, data sharing was difficult in the time before the internet. Early PDB structures were stored on paper punch cards, each containing information about one atom. The Protein Data Bank Archive was established to solve this problem. The scientists deposited the data, and the PDB copied it onto magnetic tapes and distributed them to researchers upon request. In October 1980, 10 years after the PDB was established, the PDB archive holdings contained 151 structures available for distribution. The following year, the first DNA structure was added to the PDB. In 1989, the first structure determined by a biophysical method called nuclear magnetic resonance spectroscopy, or NMR, was deposited to the PDB. In this method, a purified protein is mixed with special solvent and inserted into an NMR probe. The protein sample is then exposed to a strong magnetic field. This makes the nuclei of certain atoms, like hydrogen, spin like tops. When the sample is probed with radio waves, the nuclei become excited and resonate. The frequencies are measured and recorded. The surroundings of the atoms determine how high or how low the frequencies are. Using computational methods, the measurements are converted into a graph that represents the frequencies as peaks with specific locations for specific atom groups. This information is further refined and combined with additional NMR experiments to determine the 3D structure. The NMR method proved to be effective in solving 3D structures of smaller proteins and gave us a unique glimpse of how proteins behave in solution. In 1991, the first structure determined using 3D electron microscopy, or 3DEM, was released by the PDB. In this method, a tiny amount of purified protein is placed onto a copper grid. A special machine spreads the sample in a single layer on the grid. The sample is frozen in liquid ethane and then loaded into an electron microscope. The sample is exposed to a beam of accelerated electrons and images are captured. Usually, the proteins are in many different orientations. The images are then grouped by orientation and then combined computationally to reconstruct the 3D shape of the molecule. Atoms are fit into the map to derive the 3D structure of the protein. 3DEM has become a perfect complement to X-ray and NMR techniques. The method is very effective on large, complex assemblies that are typically difficult to study by either of the two older methods. In 1995, the PDB archive became accessible for the first time through a www website. The PDB holdings were accessible online through various services since 1988. However, the new website equipped with a browser marked a new chapter in data distribution. Researchers could still request the full archive on CD-ROM. In 1999, the 10,000th structure was released into the PDB. The distribution of the PDB archive on physical media was discontinued in 2004. By then, the internet and computer technology made it possible for all data operations to be done completely online through the FTP server and web portals maintained by the members of the newly established worldwide PDB organization. In 2008, the PDB archive reached another milestone number of entries, 50,000 structures. In 2014, the number doubled. As the PDB entered its golden year, there were more than 170,000 structures in the archive. The growing numbers of 3D structures of proteins and nucleic acids further our understanding of biology and help us explore how life works at the atomic level. Many Nobel Prizes have been awarded for projects involving molecular structures. Structural biology research is essential in addressing major public health emergencies. For example, scientists have used the structures of HIV proteins to design drugs that stop the virus from multiplying. Today, as the world faces the COVID pandemic, structural biologists are exploring its viral proteins in a quest for new therapeutics and vaccines. The PDB provides ready access to structural biology research, ensuring the quality of the data and providing tools for query, visualization, and analysis of these structures. Now, 50 years since the PDB's founding, the Protein Databank continues to be a leading global resource for experimental data that is playing a central role in scientific discovery and education.